All right, Coach Hutter, ODU down in the dirty south here, Georgia. And you and I were just talking, but ODU does not focus on one area. It has many areas, and you guys are a national recruiting. You guys recruit everywhere. You're in the Chesapeake Bay area, but you're an Illinois guy.
Yeah.
And you're a couple-time All-American there. Looking at that, though, knowing that you guys recruit everywhere and coming to the South, what's it mean to come down here and see how they're running the C3 and the college combine here?
No, it's awesome. It's awesome coming down here, seeing a little bit different style of wrestling. Georgia wrestling, Florida wrestling, see some Texas kids here. You know, wrestling's, you know, getting big everywhere. It's good to see because I know, you know, for a while, you know, it was big in the Midwest. And, you know, wrestling's definitely grown in the South. So trying to get some Georgia kids.
Looking at, you know, Virginia and looking at your guys's, you guys got a good team. You had a rough postseason, but then Makati comes back, you all Americans.
Yep.
But, you know, you guys are riddled with injuries this year. Now, Jack missed a lot of the season.
Yep.
You got a guy who wins the Midlands. He misses part of the season, the end of the season. When you look at that and the ups and downs of it, what are you looking for when you recruit a guy? You can't control injuries, but what are you guys looking for, you know, when you have your national recruiting and you're recruiting California guys, you're recruiting Illinois guys like
right,
you are,
of course,
you know, everywhere, but what are you guys looking for in a student athlete?
I mean, obviously, you know, like you said, we had the season ups and downs, but you can't control it. But, you know, when we're looking at a kid we're recruiting, obviously, you know, number one, you ask about their grades, you know, how are their grades going. Then, you ask about their work ethic because, you know, if they have a good work ethic, you know they're going to get through those ups and downs, especially throughout the season. You know, college wrestling, it's a long season. You're going to have your ups and downs, and if you can be positive when you're down, you know, things are going to get better.
Looking at how they're doing this system, you did some low single stuff this morning, some single leg attacks. You get to actually teach the guys, and you're also, now you're sitting out and you're watching.
Mm-hmm.
What's more important to you, getting the hands on or being able to watch the habits of, you know, guys you're recruiting?
Oh, both are very important. You know, obviously you like to see how they pick up things. So, you know, when you're showing it, you don't get to see that as much. Now watching it from the outside, you can see, you know, more of their work ethic, you know, how they're drilling, how many reps they're getting, you know, where they're coming from, who they are as wrestlers.
Looking at, you know, the national recruiting, you guys recruit everywhere in the country.
Yeah.
Whose philosophy is that? Is that Coach Martin's philosophy? Just recruit. It doesn't matter. We want good guys.
Yeah, you want good guys. I mean, you know, with camps, the Granby School of Wrestling, you know, you build a lot of relationships across the country. I mean, it's where you got a kid like Chris Makati, you know, going through the Granby School of Wrestling since he was 8 years old. And now we have that relationship. California kids see they can come out east and be successful at our school. So you look for the relationships, you know.
Looking at, you know, like Jack Dekow, that guy, I mean, he was fourth as a freshman.
Mm-hmm.
He's failed to place the last 2 years. Going into his senior year, I think you guys got guys back, and you have a, you know, a team that can come back and you can challenge for a MAC title. What do you guys look for out of leadership? You know, Jack's obviously going to be a senior for you. What are you looking for in leadership and guys?
Oh, leadership. You know, you want them to set by example. You know, Jack, obviously, you know, postseasons, you know, it's a tough time of year. Things don't always go your way, and, you know, injuries, you know, who you run into, things like that. But, you know, we're excited to have Kevin Beasley back off his Olympic redshirt. You know, guys like Emilio Saavedra, you know, starting to come into his own, you know, be in that room every single day, you know, show their work ethic, show by example.
Do you, you're an Illinois guy.
Yeah.
Do you kind of like, I'm an Ohio guy.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm partial to Ohio. Are you partial to Illinois? Are you trying to bring more Illinois guys in?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, Illinois, you know, all my family's still there, so I do like going out that way. And, you know, I know a lot more people, you know, from there than, you know, the other parts of the country. But, you know, that's definitely going to be, you know, a state that we're looking into, you know, like others, like you said, you know, that national front.
All right, you got anything else for me?
Yeah, go Monarchs.
Hey, thanks for the time. Safe travels.
Thanks a lot.